you're doing away with the stock air box, you can go ahead and take this out also. Alright, once you get to this point, there's a clamp right down in here. I don't know if you can see that or not. You can see the screw right there. Go ahead and take the clamp off or loosen it on the side that the carburetor's on. There's a clamp on the engine side and the carburetor side. You just need to loosen the carburetor side. Alright, you just want to loosen these nuts up for your throttle cable, and that'll pop right off that bracket right there. And then you can come down here, and it should pop right off. That'll pop right out of there. And then you got one more to do the same thing. Loosen that nut up. Pop it off that bracket. Get a little slack on it. Might need to turn your raise that up. Alright, this hose was on here. You just pop that off. You got one in the back. Also, go ahead and pop that one off. Other side. This is your fuel inlet for your carburetor. It's easier just to pull it off here and leave that hose attached to your carburetor when you pull it off. Depending on what year you have, you might have a wire going to your carburetor that you have to unplug, and that'll be right up top here. All right, if you have one of these plugs on your carburetor, just know that they are very hard to get out. You got a clip on this side, a clip on this side, and a clip on the top. So you almost need to pry up under here, here, and here at the same time just to get it. All right, next you have two hoses down bottom, and just put a rag underneath those because they're gonna have some antifreeze in them. Just try to remember which one goes where. The longer one is gonna go on the outside, the shorter one's gonna go to the inside. Thank you. All right, first you want to take this cotter pin out. Right there. And there's a little washer underneath of it. Swing that to the side. These screws are really soft and easy to strip, so you want to be careful with those. There's a little notch right here. So when you're putting it back together, just make sure you get that in the right spot. It's going to go right over top of this right here. A Phillips head screw down in here, plastic one, you just turn that, loosen it. Come right out of there. And there's your needle. Separate the float bowl. Alright, when you're rejetting the carb, the best luck I've had is go with the Donna Jet DJ1197 kit. All you really need out of it is the needle. The jets, I don't use any of the jets that come with it. You get a 122, you get a 126, and a 130. I actually order a 142 from jetsrus.com, and that's what I use for my main jet. So I'm going to replace the main jet with that. I'm going to replace the needle with the one from the Donna jet kit. We're going to set the E-clip on the fourth notch down. And to get that to fit, a lot of times you have to cut the top two notches off. And I'll show you how to do that. You just want to look at your pilot jet to make sure it's all clean before you put it back together. Might need to use a backup wrench to get this main jet out of here. It's a 7mm. I don't have a 7mm wrench. I'm just going to put an adjustable on it. If your gasket's in pretty good shape, you can probably just go ahead and reuse that. That's what I'm going to do in this case. Alright, since you're going to be jetting the carburetor, you're going to have to reset your air fuel screw here. Just screw it all the way in. You're going to lightly seat it, and then you want to back it off 3 turns. Thank you. I make a little mark on the side of my tool so I know how many times I'm turning it. Kind of hard to know otherwise. One. Two. Three. All right, so if you can't get your needle to fit back in your carb, you're gonna have to cut the top two notches off. That's what I usually have to do. So just like a wrapping on a piece of paper towel so this vise doesn't mess it up or anything. Put that in there. And just take a Dremel or something and just count one, two from the top. Alright, when you're putting your diaphragm back in, just make note that this little notch right here, whatever you want to call it, is going to go right here where that cutout is on the top of your carburetor. Go ahead and drop your needle down in there. Again, we've got that E-clip set on the fourth notch down before we cut it. So after you cut it, you're going to have it on the second from the top. And you're going to take your little washer that came with the needle and stick that right on top of your E-clip. Next is your little plastic piece here. And then same thing on this, there's a little notch right there on the edge. That's gonna go right there on that little piece that sticks off your diaphragm. Just put your spring right in there like that. Okay, then you're just going to hook this piece back up I broke my little cotter pin when I was pulling it out, so I'm gonna have to see if I can get a new one of those. When you're putting this plug back on, you really need to make sure that these clips engage in each three spots, because that plug will go in there, but this piece here doesn't always want to go up in there. So you just got to make sure it's, you can see the little tabs on each spot.